Hey, I got this ice cream and I was telling you about it, I think. I asked for half price drinks and slushies from 3 to 5 p.m. I asked for a mini. She gave me a medium. So I'm never gonna eat all this. I'll probably eat all this, let's be real. Oh my gosh, we're next. Okay. Anyway, I've been sitting in my car for like, what is that? Oh, that happens all the time. Oh, is it my mirror? Oh no, it's just the shadow of my door. Okay, anyway, now that I jacked up my rearview mirror, I've been sitting in my car for a while and just thinking, and I don't want to go inside. For no reason, I just don't. Oh, that was crazy. So we're gonna have a chat. Stop. Stop trying to find your love and, or like, find love and things in this world. Quit looking for it from a boy and from being the most liked or having the most friends. None of that matters. It's really, really not fulfilling. I've been searching for years. My whole life, I've just been saying, oh, I just want to be loved. Like, that's all I want. I just want people to like me. I want to make people happy. And I haven't found that in people. I've looked. But I know where to find it. See? This guy named Jesus. Oh! Peep the Jesus Loves You merch. And he literally has everything I need. And he's perfect. And he never ever gets tired of me. He never gets mad at me. He always wants me. But yet, I run away so many times. I've been running for a while now. At least, like, definitely since I got to Corbin and like this summer too. I just, what I deserve now. I grew up in the church and everything, and I was that like golden child. I was that perfect kid, bro. I literally never did anything wrong. I had like a 4.0. Oh, sorry, a 3.967, because I got an A- in one class, freshman year, one semester. We didn't talk about that. I literally never did anything bad. I never snuck out, never drank, never did, like, I wasn't, like, a liar. I didn't steal. I was, like, super nice and, like, wanted to make everybody like me and stuff and, like, wanted my parents to be proud of me and was always trying to live up to everyone's expectations. I was the student leader, you know. I preached at my youth group. I was a small group leader for, like, kids. I led devos. I wrote sermon discussion questions. And then I started to get a little bit of independence. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is so much fun. I can do whatever I want. I don't always have to do what everyone told me I have to do. And my relationship with Mike ended for the last time. So the third time Mike broke my heart, it was over. And that was right after I came here. And I met somebody who was a really, really, really great guy. It made me really happy. And I had fun. But the fun that I was having is not glorifying the Lord. The fun that I was having was earthly fun. And it was superficial things, and it was instant gratification.
It was drinking and sex and partying, and
I was safe the whole time. I was with Austin. He wouldn't hurt me, but I made some not good choices because I thought that I would feel loved from it. Because I just wanna be loved. I wanna be what somebody wants. And so I'm always doing what they want me to do. And this isn't to say like that I was pressured. Austin never told me. I mean, he invited me to his party, but I told him I wasn't gonna drink. Like when I first met him. I met him on literally Tinder, okay? I'm the one that got on Tinder. And he never pressured me to do anything. You know, he always asked me what I wanted to do and like made sure that I was okay with everything, comfortable. And I am hurting because we know that we aren't what each other needs, and he doesn't love Jesus like I do. And he said that I needed to go be with somebody who does love Jesus. And so yesterday we decided to end things, but it hurts because I know that this is God telling me to come back to him. God taking away the things that were taking me away from God. So that I would... It's God saying, stop running. But I wasn't done running yet, you know? I was mad, and I wanted to be mad, and I wanted to keep running. And I think that I know that this is what's supposed to happen, because I think I would have kept running. And that's not right. And it sucks because the love that I want, the love that I'm looking for, is the love that I'll find in Jesus. But the people I look for it in help me feel it a lot better than Jesus does, right? I'm a touch person. Jesus doesn't hold my hand. He doesn't stroke my face or pull me in at the waist or anything. And it's hard because, like, I serve a father who knows my needs. And he sees my pain, but he can't meet my needs like that, right? Jesus isn't just gonna come sit in the... How crazy if Jesus came and sat in the car right now next to me. Whoa. But anyway, He's not gonna just... I don't know. He doesn't do it the way I want him to. Can you imagine? The God of the universe wants to do things the way he wants to do them instead of the way that sinner Tiffany wants to do them? What? Crazy! But yeah. So, basically, I went to chapel this week for like the first time in a month, probably. We had this extra credit assignment for speech where if we like did an out of class observation, we could get extra credit, and I need the extra credit. So I went, and God just spoke to me there, man. It was just like, we talked about rest, like finding rest in God and just taking a minute to stop and have solitude with the Lord. And I was just sitting there and I was like, oh my gosh, awkward. Wait. Whoa, okay. I was just sitting there and I was like, oh my gosh. Jesus is speaking to me, dude. Like, I just felt the Lord, like, calling me back home. And I went up and I talked to the preacher and I told him how much it meant to me. And I really enjoyed his sermon and stuff. And I still didn't want to listen, though. And now I'm sitting here and I'm ready to listen. So my best advice for you is that you'll only find the love you're seeking in Jesus. wants to give it to you. He wants you to come home. He's calling you. He's calling me.
Maybe it couldn't work out.
So here I am.
In the end.
Deciding to stop running. Come back to
maybe
God.
This what I deserve.
And say that His grace is sufficient for me. I don't need the validation or approval or romantic love from a man, because I have the perfect and complete and infinite love of God. I already have that. I don't have to do anything to earn it. And now I'm like weeping. This is so embarrassing. I'm gonna have to edit this like way down. But anyway. Just stop running. He wants you back.